Hello, this is Bern, and if you'd love to stop worrying incessantly about whether the guy's falling for you or if he's really into you, well, stick around because I'm going to be sharing with you how to stop this insanity once and for all on my episode today. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetoday.com. Today's another edition of Get the Love You Crave. And I'm gonna be sharing with you how to stop feeling worried and anxious unnecessarily about a guy that may be falling for you, or maybe you're not sure if he's really into you and you're feeling anxious when you date. Not when you connect to the dude that you're not really into, but when you connect to the guy that you feel, man, he would be such an amazing husband or partner for life or just boyfriend, that you don't feel that weight that makes you show up with fear and anxiety and stop thinking about the things that are important in your life, okay? The first step to stop dating anxiously is to stop lying to yourself, right? Here's the thing. If you connect to a guy that you feel might be an amazing guy, but you tell yourself, he's the most amazing guy I've met in the last 5 years, you're lying to yourself. Why? Because you have no fucking idea who he is. You infer that he is the most amazing guy you've met over the last 5 years, but you really don't know. So what I want you to start doing, instead of lying to yourself, and you're not consciously lying to yourself, nobody does that, right? But you are, is to base your thoughts on the man on the hypothesis principle. Here's how it goes. Instead of saying, he's the most amazing guy I've met, is he appears to be. That small change in semantics changes your life. Because when you say he appears to be, then you no longer put the weight of it has to work out, or or I know for sure, this is a universal law that the guy is that. Hypothesis could be wrong all the time, and you're not gonna blame yourself if you have the wrong hypothesis. You'll continue to make better ones, but I just want you to stop doing what a lot of women who really want love to take place unknowingly do, which is project. Imagine that I show you right now a word, and I take away maybe 3 or 4 letters in that word. If it's done the right way, you're still gonna be able to come up with that or infer what word that is. With guys, it's not the same thing. Sometimes a guy at the beginning shows up and you think, well, this 10 letters that are missing, not just one or two, 10 letters that are missing, this is exactly what word it spells. And it's a completely different word. I want you to stop doing that, okay? Stop projecting shit that is not really there, and take time to really get a chance to know this guy. The time factor is the undeniable quality that will allow you to know for sure if he is who he says he is. And if you're aligned the way you feel and your heart feels and your hormones feel that you're aligned with at the beginning. Number two is never choose a guy who doesn't clearly choose you. Now, I'm not saying that if the guy's not calling you 25 times a day that you say, well, he didn't choose me, but why would you settle for a guy who's kind of wishy-washy, who shows up strong 2 days and then forgets you the next 2 weeks and then shows up strong again and then forgets you for another, like, maybe 5 weeks? Don't choose guys who are not clear in their intention to pursue you. And again, at the beginning, it's not going to be as clear as it will be later. But if you don't see a progression in how the guy is treating you, making time for you and pursuing you, don't waste your time. Number four, keep dating until it happens. Why do I say this? Because it's so common that I see a woman who connects with a guy, infers, instead of the hypothesis thing, she says out the window, he is the most amazing guy I've met, so projects a lot, and then the guy is not necessarily choosing her so much, she starts feeling anxious, starts showing up as needy, starts pursuing the dude, and also, to fuck things up even worse, stops dating other guys. So what happens when you stop dating other guys? You make up fantasies about this dude. You waste your time, because if it doesn't work out, and chances are it may not work out, then you maybe 5 months later, you could have spent those 5 months simultaneously creating other relationships. One of those could have been your husband, the father of your children, your lifelong partner, and you chose to just put all your eggs in one basket of a dude that wasn't clearly pursuing you and for whom you made a lot of projections. So stop doing that. So number one, let's recap again. Number one, stop lying to yourself. Create hypotheses instead of universal laws about men. Number two, don't choose men who don't clearly pursue you. And number three, keep dating other guys until it happens. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do 3 things. Number one, click like on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Number three, on the description of this video, you will see, or a pop-up here, you will see a way for you to sign up to a free video that I created for you, a masterclass that will share with you how you can create the connection you want with your soulmate with a lot less pain and a lot quicker than you would on your own. And all you do is you click on that link, takes you to a page where you can click on a yellow bar and then enter your name and email, and then you'll be set. Thank you so much for showing up today. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.